Phelps and Bukowski, LAPD. We are investigating the attempted murder of June Ballard and Jessica Hamilton.
Christ! I'm Marlon Hopgood. How can I help?
You hold castings here?
How'd you hear about that? I got a little soundstage out back.
Lead the way. Keep him here, Stefan. I'm gonna take a look around.
What's this got to do with me?
Don't try my patience, knucklehead.
Turn off the lights, Hopgood.
Why would I want to do that?
Humor it.
One-way mirrors. There's a room on the other side.
Huh. Well, well. Find a way into that peep den, Phelps. I'll stay here and keep our pervert company.
Doping a 15-year-old kid and abusing her in a screen test. What is wrong with these people?
Jungle Drums, 8th and Francisco. Attention, Mark Bishop.
So what happened to the film of Hamilton's screen test? I wonder if they saw this, how many budding starlets would still get on the bus to come to Hollywood.
Listen, I have to call you back. I got some business here.
Sit down, Courtney. This is Mickey. Mickey, this is Courtney Sheldon. What would you like to drink?
Scotch. Straight up.
I hear you're back at school learning to be a doctor, kid.
Yes. That's right, Mr. Cohen.
So you want to be a doctor and a dope peddler? Interesting combination, huh?
Do we have a problem, Mr. Cohen?
We might have, yeah. Selling your dope to my boy Lenny looked like a good move, but Lenny has been supplying, wholesale, so to speak. The Bindle boys in this town aren't used to the juice without a little of the middleman taking his cut.
Lenny promised that wouldn't happen, Mr. Cohen. And Lenny works for you.
What can I say about Lenny? Let me think. Oh yeah, he's a putz. And he's lazy, and he's greedy, but he's my wife's brother. And how can you make a cake with those ingredients, huh? Please.
So how is that my problem, Mr. Cohen?
Well, kid, the only way we're going to be able to make this work is to do some repackaging. We need to get the dope out of those dinky little cardboard boxes and...
Surettes.
Yeah, surettes. Great. We can put it into a big vat so we can water it down a little bit.
I won't bore you with the chemistry, but it doesn't work that way. You're likely to kill even more people.
Okay, listen. We want to buy you out, kid. I'll offer you $50,000. Hey, you don't like my offer? The Sheldon kid? I think I want him dead.
Doesn't tell me anything. Don't think this is any use to us.
Advice? You ever do any work for Mark Bishop?
Mainly do work for the studios. RKO, Republic, Warner Brothers. So yeah, when Bishop is doing work for a studio, yes.
When did you last see him?
Now I'm doing work for his next picture. Still pre-production though. Haven't seen him around here in a while.
He was here yesterday, and something happened that pushed him over the edge. You're holding out on us, Hopgood.
You know, I have very good connections with the Vice Squad.
And well, there's a surprise.
They won't appreciate you coming in here and strong-arming me.
McAfee's men are looking for Bishop. We need to find him first. Any idea where he might have gone to ground?
If he really tried to kill McAfee's wife, my advice to him would be to leave town.
You're delivering props to Jungle Drums on 8th Street?
Bishop is using that old rundown wreck of a set. That place is dangerous. But it might be a good spot to hide.
That's all for now, Hopgood. We're taking you in.
Phelps! Roy Earle, add Vice. Hold on a moment. This is clearly a Vice case. You've been roughing up my informant?
Hopgood is a Vice informer?
Yes, he is, Phelps, and a very important one. Look at that mug. Have you been upsetting these two officers, Marlin?
So we just drop it?
You do if you know what's good for you.
You need to catch the movie producer before an angry husband does, from what I'm hearing.
I'll be making a full report to the captain, detective.
You do that, kid. We're all very impressed with you. Let it slide, Cole. Let's get out of here.
Detectives!
Johnny Goldberg, you work for Mickey C.
That's right, detectives.
You wouldn't happen to know the guys who roughed up Mrs. Bishop earlier today, by any chance?
No, no, not us. We don't do that kind of thing. It's the husband we'd like to talk to.
This is a police matter. You don't want to be taken in for obstruction of justice, do you, boys?
You could try the obstruction rap, but it won't stick. We could beat that.
You've had your 10 cents worth, gentlemen.
Bishop knows how the world works. Mrs. McAfee hits him up for a movie part. Happens every day. But Bishop takes it a step too far and tries to rub out Mrs. McAfee. Naturally, Guy is going to get upset.
What made you think Bishop would be here?
We figure he might be planning a little accident for Hopgood, too. Those two guys have got some unfinished business. You let us know if you find Bishop. Guy McAfee can be a very generous man.
I'm only going to warn you once, gentlemen. Stay out of this. This is a police matter. We will be bringing Mark Bishop into custody.
At least he's polite. Kind of dumb, but polite.
But I'm a lot less polite, you smug son of a bitch. So let me put it in ruder terms that even a pair of blockheads like you might understand. The only reason that you don't have bars on your windows already is because you're small fry. And we don't waste our time on small fry. You stay away from Bishop, and you stay away from me. Is that clear enough for you, asshole? Now run along back to your boss so we can pat you on the head and tell you what good boys you are.
This ain't working traffic is like watching paint dry.
You know how to piss people off, Dinkowski.
Hey, if they're prepared to gun down...
You can drive.
All right. Where to?
That's that cop. Seems like a decent guy.
Quality taste punches.
Seems like we're the only ones who want Bishop alive.
I have a good mind just to let him go work on the son of a bitch. I'm about done putting my life on the line to protect some child molester.
That's our job, unfortunately. They don't get to dole out the justice.
There's the slippery bastard now.
No. God damn it!
Mark Bishop, stop! LAPD!
Get him, Phelps. I'll cover the exit.
11K calling KGPO. Requesting assistance at 8 San Francisco. An abandoned movie set. My partner is pursuing suspects on foot.
Code we're trying to help you, Bishop. KGPL. This is all a big mistake.
Us or McAfee's boys, your choice.
I didn't do anything.
Get the hell out of here, you goddamn maniac! enough.
Let's go, make it all up.
Harder on yourself, Bishop.
It's Duke Ballard. He's blackmailing me.
Hands in the air, Bishop. Move another inch and you're dead.
Mark Bishop, you're under arrest for the attempted murder of June Ballard and the rape and attempted murder of Jessica Hamilton.
All right, now come quietly. Just don't kill me. If you found me, then McAfee's goons will too. Oh, we need to get out of here.
All right, but you stay close. Any tricks, and I'll save McAfee's boys the trouble.
Follow me. I know another way out of this place. Christ, detectives, they're trying to kill me!
Last chance to back the hell down.
It's this way.
There's no way out of here. I thought you said you knew where you were going.
We have to jump for it.
LAPD, you're making a big mistake.
Kill a cop. That was the electric chair.
Come on, it's this way. Get to the car. We can't be over here.
Now, this is what I call a result. Mark Bishop, erstwhile film producer, an all-around piece of shit, catches a fast ticket to Quentin for statch rape and attempted murder. So he gets to spend the next 15 years playing sissy instead of sticking it to little girls. That is justice with a capital J, Detective Phelps. You developed such a reputation, I'm not going to be able to hold on to you any longer. You're getting promoted. Go on, get your new assignment. It was good working with you, son.
Phelps, Bukowski, this your work?
Can I help you, Detective?
Sorry, Cap, didn't see you there.
Yeah, I'll bet you didn't. This is a traffic case. You need something?
I'm here to buy a drink for the two LAPD traffic cops who broke the back of Guy McAfee's private army. You don't have a problem with that, do you, Captain?
Go right ahead.
Get in. I'm buying. You like jazz, Cole? The hopheads love it.
Sure, I guess.
Big bands and swing, I can understand, but this bebop palaver? How are you supposed to dance to that? This is Phelps, Leroy. Be nice to him. You'll like this place. They treat you right.
Would you like a table, Roy?
What do you think we want to do? Stand at the bar like
I'll
chumps?
I'll get a table ready for you.
Don't look so happy to see me, Alphonse. I might get the wrong impression. Cole, this is Alphonse. He's a French Negro from Africa. Can you beat that?
The Congo.
A pleasure to meet you, Alphonse.
Is Elsa singing tonight?
Yes, she is. She has the next set.
Come on, Cole. You can meet Elsa while they're fixing us a table. You'll like her. She's something else.
Maybe another night, Roy. She's pretty beat up about it.
Get your hands off me. Don't ever tell me what to do or what not to do, Alphonse. You got a nice club here. Don't spoil it.
If you will follow me, detectives. Just through the door.
It was my only real friend, Harlan. We went through it all. Do you realize what he meant to me?
Of course I do.
You have no idea. You said it was construction work.
It was an industrial accident, Elsa. How can I be held responsible?
Elsa, are you going on?
Louis, for God's sake, he was my best friend. The only man who ever loved me without putting his hands on me.
Hi, Elsa. Here's someone I'd like you to meet. Cole Phelps, war hero and crime fighter extraordinaire.
And why would I want to meet another fascist from the LAPD?
Sorry about this, Cole. What an evening I'm having. First a Negro puts his hands on me, and then this. Who do you think you're talking to, you German junkie whore? Don't you ever forget your place with me again. Do you hear me? Evening, Doc. How's business?
Sanguine. Louis, help me here. I'm gonna have to give her something before her performance.
Blow it off, Cole. These artsy-fartsy types always get a little flighty. Meet Dr. Harlan Fontaine, doctor to the stars. Mr. Fix-It to the mental wreckage of Hollywood. So what about that drink, boys?
Thank you.
All right, gentlemen, take your seats. Let's get this over before lunch. Clyde Rose of the Homicide Squad has decided to take early retirement. We will all miss Floyd and the steely edge he brought to his police work. The department has arranged a wee drink at the Galway Arms to quench the mighty thirst a man gets from 25 years of police work. Floyd's departure leaves a place at the top table, and the chief has seen fit to promote Cole Phelps from burglary to the homicide desk. Stand up, Phelps. Take a chair. You're in the major leagues now, Sonny. Rusty Galloway, a fine lawman of the old school, will be taking you under his wing. Your first case is the murder of a woman found last night and bearing all the signs of the werewolf. Get out to the scene, lads.
Do you have the address?
It's been all over KGPL. It's off Temple Street, between Belmont and Glendale.
Are you drunk, mister? Or are you just cracked?
What happened to Rose?
Both of us, Chief John. Word is, it's either going to be him or Thad. And they're both clearing the desk.
Where does that leave you, Galloway?
Leaves me saddled with a chump like you. I didn't ask for you, and I don't want you, so keep it to yourself. See if you can learn something about seeing how a real cop is.
What did he mean by the werewolf?
The Galleon. The Daily News came out calling him the werewolf. The Examiner came up with the Black Galleon.
Were any closer to catching him?
Not a chance. 6 months and hundreds of guys running down leads, and we got nothing.
I don't think this has anything to do.
No, I don't. 90% of murders are domestic. Some guy gets into a beef with his wife, he takes it too far. It'll be the same. But cutting someone in half and leaving them off in sight.
Any central unit, car 16A, reports a possible jumper at 8th and Hope, the Methodist Church in Escanaba, code to identify.
11K, go ahead.
I'll do it! So help me God, I'll jump!
You need to get up there.
Let me do the talking, detective. I know a ton of this psychology stuff. You take the back alley and find a way up there.
Come on, Phelps, let's get moving.
Are you jumping? Make sure you warn me before you do.
I will! Wait! What?
You think this thing can hold you, Rusty?
I'll bring you down with me, Phelps.
No offense, but I don't want you splashed on my shoes.
Are you crazy? What are you trying to do?
I remember my first jumper. I could have soaked him up with a sponge. I still can't eat spaghetti sauce.
This what you wanted?
I can't do it. I'll come quietly. I need some help. Please. You gotta get me some help.
You're a danger to yourself and to others.
Know what's happening before you hit the belt. Get out of the way!
Keep on going through here. Stay on this road. I need you to take a left at the next corner. Not killing the people to pay our salaries.
How about a scoop for the Examiner, Galloway? You could use some good press.
Another tramp, another message. Is the werewolf back in business, boys?
Do you have a mother, asshole? A sister? How about showing some respect for this poor woman? Let us do our job, and Detective Galloway will give you a statement later.
He's good, Rusty. He even sounds genuine.
That's Phelps, guys. The war hero. Defending the honor of murdered humps.
You're used to it, Phelps. Moving along, guys. You got your pictures, you got your headlines. Now scram!
Patrolman, this your beat?
Yes, sir. Well, part of it. Kids park here, they use it like a lover's lane. It's a working neighborhood. Some trouble, but nothing like this. It's known locally as the Moors.
You were first on the scene?
Yes, Detective.
No one's disturbed the body?
No, sir. We cleared out them vulture reporters so Pinker in the corner could work. They're waiting to talk to you.
Go house to house and see what you come up with. Cause of death?
It could be the head injuries. She has been badly stomped. The cuts look superficial. I'll know for sure in an hour.
What about this wound on the finger?
Something removed. A ring, most likely. I assume it was taken post-mortem.
What caused the blunt force injury to the face?
Could be anything from a baseball bat to a lug wrench. I'll have more details after the autopsy.
Interesting.
What's the writing on the victim mean?
BD, like Dahlia? Hex? Your guess is as good as mine. Could be something to it, or it could be the killers trying to throw you off the scent. Either way, I'll run tests on the lipstick.
Any idea of the time of death?
From the temperature, I'd say after midnight. I'll confirm with you later.
Looks like some kind of puzzle or parlor game.
Bomba Club. Why steal a table lighter?
Optimistic, Cole.
The victim's bag? Looks brand new. Can't be the one used on the body. What can you tell me about the shoe prints?
Men's size 8s. Tinker lifted impressions for me to compare back at the lab.
Can we get to the Bomba? A man could die of thirst on a case like this.
You can drive.
Fine. Where are we headed?
The werewolf?
For my money, a copycat.
We can't rule it out. We need to work the evidence.
You'd love that, wouldn't you? A big head to hang on your wall. The caller of the decade. They've been working evidence on BD case for 6 months and got nicks.
There's a difference, Rusty.
Oh, yeah?
I just started working it today.
Okay, Oddshot. What's more likely? The werewolf comes back around, leaving us a note in a corpse?
He clearly has a thing for power. Power over women. Why not power over the police department as well?
Let me finish, Phelps. A guy opens his mouth again after 6 months of stewing. Or some opportunist who's been reading about the BD figures, he'll rip off the MO and get himself a freebie.
That's not totally fantastical.
Well, the Examiner and the Daily News might be good at coming up with monikers, but they're terrible for police work. There's a reason we didn't get the son of a bitch after the short murder. It was them, locusts.
Where do you think the werewolf killer is now?
Dead by his own hand, stationed somewhere else with the armed forces. San Quentin, another town, another country, who knows? So, Phelps, I understand you want to turn this into a big case, but it doesn't work like that, all right? A case will come and find you. You can't make it something it ain't, understand?
So you don't think the werewolf has continued to operate in the Los Angeles area?
No chance. Found.
Sam has taken me to Palm Springs for the weekend.
Where is that?
Gentlemen, what can I get you?
Phelps and Galloway, LAPD. Were you working here last night?
Yes. How can I help, officer?
You can start with your name.
Garrett Mason.
You're the regular bartender on nights?
I'm a temporary barman. I work for an agency. I fill in at bars across town.
Do you remember a woman who came in here last night? 5'7", about 110 pounds, blonde hair, about 40 years of age.
You mean Celine Henry?
Yes. Do you know anything about her?
I don't. But the owner, Mr. McCall, serves her most nights. Would you like to speak to him?
I would.
He sits at the back of the club. Wears a hibiscus. You can't miss him. Is there anything else?
Inquire away, Phelps. I'll stay here. I'm a little parched. Pour me three fingers of rye.
Can you cover my shift on Wednesday?
Have fun. So, how's your tuna fish salad?
Detective Phelps, LAPD. We're investigating the murder of Celine Henry. Do you know her?
Celine?
You going Christ. To pay for that?
Sure, I know her. She and I and Jacob, her husband, we go way back.
She was here last night?
Pour me another.
Sure, she's a regular. Celine is... was a lovely woman.
Was Mrs. Henry here with anyone last night?
Not at first. Celine already had quite a head start.
But she attracted attention?
Certainly. A few gentlemen became very enamored with her and her stories. One guy in particular.
You know him?
No. He's been in a couple of times.
Did they leave together?
Yes. At around 11. If it helps, I made the guy's license plate.
I think this could be a great help, sir. Thank you. Mrs. Henry appeared to be missing a ring, torn from her finger, but not her wedding finger.
Celine always wore a red garnet ring on the large side. Larger than life, like Celine herself.
Did she have it a long time?
Sure. Since way back in her flying days.
Did her husband buy it for her?
No, it was before Jacob.
I think you know where the ring came from, and I think you're gonna tell me.
Okay. I bought it years ago. I carried a torch for Celine in those days. Guess I always have. Her old man never knew about it.
You know the husband?
Sure I know Jacob. He was in the Corps. He met Celine on a furlough and married her when the war was finished. He put up with a load of shit.
Do you think he killed his wife?
No. No, not in my opinion.
Was he ever violent with her?
Celine came in here last night looking like she'd taken a slap. They don't live together anymore, so it might not have been him.
Thanks, Mr. McColl. You've been a big help. One more thing. Would you have an address for Celine?
142 North Union Avenue. God knows, I had to send her home in enough cabs to remember that.
So, how's your tuna fish salad?
My egg's runny.
Let's get out of here.
Hey, what's the hurry? My stool was just starting to warm up nicely.
Doesn't give me anything to go on.
Operator, message for KGPL.
Putting you through now.
Phelps, 1247.
How could I help, Detective?
I need a registered owner on a license plate, 2BOY8899.
Yes, Detective. I'll need to contact the DMV. Shall I relay the details via KGPL?
Please. Thanks, ma'am.
Sam has taken me to Palm Springs for the weekend.
Can you drive to this one?
And where exactly are we going?
Boy, howdy.
You find the booze helps you get through a working day?
Sharpens my investigatory instincts, folks.
A smart lawyer might use that to throw out anything you collect today.
A smart man might know it's unwise to stand between the patient and his medicine.
As long as you're not falling over, Rusty, I'll let it slide.
That's mighty kind of you, Phelps. You know, you picked the wrong job of a healthy thirst to fend you, Cole.
We owe it to this city to do the best we can in this position. As homicide detectives, that responsibility is all the more serious.
Always the politician.
It's not political, it's practical. Maybe the men combing Hollywood Boulevard after the Elizabeth Short murder were more interested in sniffing out booze than the clues that would have led to her killer.
Yeah, well, if only you'd been there, choir boy. Betty Short would be alive, the Japs would have spared Pearl Harbor. Our ancestors wouldn't have tasted the forbidden fruit.
Minor syntactical error, Detective Galloway. I never claimed to be able to prevent crimes. I only suggested a proficiency in solving them. Guess that's the drink slowing you down.
Oh my God, brother, oh brother. Worse than I could ever have imagined.
Try the back door. Wait here a second. Side window's been jimmied. Looks like somebody's creeped the joint.
You said I had to go back, Doctor.
The fires are cathartic. They allow you to confront your past.
You said the house would be empty.
Are you taking the medication I have prescribed?
You said the house would be empty. I heard them screaming.
Circumstances were unfortunate. My colleagues had made all the necessary arrangements.
You said the house would be empty. You're killing me!
The deaths were unfortunate. But you have dealt with death before.
I want you to come to the clinic and we can deal with
it. You said the house would be empty! How can I find peace?
Nothing significant.
Tiffany, the rest of this stuff is junk. Might explain the missing ring. Regular Amelia Earhart per day. The ring looks distinctive.
Maybe if... No.
It would take a smarter man than me to connect that. Selene and Jacob are obviously having problems.
speaks to motive.
Crime scene evidence still weighs against it being the husband, but Jacob could give us something to go on. One of my exes drank like this, you'd be feeling the back of my hand.
Call in burglary and get technical services out here. I'll talk to the neighbors.
Don't take all day about it, Phelps. I'll get nasty when I'm thirsty. Galloway, homicide, badge number 564. Requesting technical services for a suspected 459 at 142 North Union.
Size nines, above average for a lady. Doesn't appear to be connected.
Wasn't safe around here.
LAPD, are you acquainted with Celine Henry, Miss...
Horgan! Jennifer Horgan. I've known Celine for more than 10 years. Our children grew up together. What's going on, officer?
Did you see Mrs. Henry go out last night?
Well, I'm no busybody, you understand, but... Celine had been drinking. And she and poor, long-suffering Jacob had a terrible row. I think Jacob may have given her a black eye. He stormed out and she went back inside.
Did he come back?
No. Celine was listening to music and shouting until she left around 10 p.m. She was very drunk to have been driving. But she is not the sort of person you can stop from doing something when her dander is up. What is this about, officer? Is Celine all right?
I'm afraid Mrs. Henry has been murdered, ma'am.
Murdered? Oh, my God. I'm afraid I need to go and sit down.
Let's see what Jacob has to say for himself.
I don't think Jacob is our man, but we should see what he has to say.
Jacob Henry had a violent argument with his wife last night. He's looking more and more likely.
For my money, the broad keeps the house looking like that, he probably deserved it. The skipper says bring him in. Keep the hacks off his back for a while.
Fine by me.
So it ain't the werewolf killer after all. Good to see you come to your senses, boy.
I always said work the evidence. I only stipulated a connection to the BD killer as an avenue of investigation we should leave open. And as far as I'm concerned, it still is.
Breathe, Phelps. Breathe, damn it! If we survive this, it's gonna be a miracle. Follow my lead. You Jacob Henry?
Yeah. Who's asking?
LAPD. You're under arrest for the murder of your wife, Celine Henry.
Murder? Celine?
Save the dramatics RKO, pal. You got bigger problems.
What the hell are you talking about? You come in here, you tell me that Celine is...
Take a seat, Mr. Henry.
That she's...
We're gonna have a look around, then we'll talk.
Jesus, I'm sorry.
I get even the slightest hint that you're a flight risk, pal.
Not sure this means much.
Atmosphere's thick in here. Wait till you try the gas chamber. He'll be back in a few minutes. Sit tight.
Oldest problem there is, what to do about the old lady.
Size 11s.
So who could have killed Celine? Where did she go last night, Jacob?
A bar, I suppose. Look, I don't know.
We get the impression that Celine liked to live the glamorous life. How did she end up with a hump like you, Jacob?
Celine was one of the first woman pilots. She hung out with movie stars and royalty. Came back here broke and struggling. She married a mechanic. Put a roof over her head, food on the table. Not glamorous, but the best I could do. I'm not ashamed about that.
When did you last see your wife, Mr. Henry?
Last night. I went to see her. We talked. Things got a little out of hand.
I left. That's a lie, and you know it. You tailed her, watched her come out of a bar, and then beat her to death. Admit it, Henry.
Why would I do that, Detective? My wife was a drunk. It was a sickness with her. Doesn't mean I didn't love her. Would you stop loving your wife if she was unwell?
No, I wouldn't. Why did you kill her, Jacob? Things will go better if you come clean about it.
That's a lousy thing to say. I never gave up on my wife.
I don't believe you, Jacob. I think you didn't have the guts to do it yourself, so you had someone else do it.
You want to back that up with something, Big Mouth? Huh?
The note by the phone suggests you meant her harm.
You want the truth? Truth is, I was sick to death of her. I was trying to have her committed.
So you can prove that you came back here after you left your wife's place.
I came back here. I was here all night. Start work at 6:30. Not the going out type.
Did a neighbor see you? Did you talk to anyone? You need an alibi, Jacob.
I don't have one. I was here. I listened to Amos and Andy on the radio, and then I went to bed.
We're still gonna need you to come downtown, Mr. Henry.
We can get this all down on paper, Jacob. How you got fed up with your wife, and how you figured killing her would bury all your troubles.
Kill my own wife?
She was a lush and a tramp, and you just couldn't stand it anymore.
Shut your goddamn mouth.
So now you're gonna tell me you loved her? Ah, the DA goes all gooey over remorse, Jacob.
You're awful hot.
Just...
What's this bunk?
It doesn't look...
Call it in and get a squad car dispatched. And check for messages. I'll keep old Slugger here company.
Operator, give me dispatch.
Putting you through now.
Phelps, badge 1247.
How can I help, Detective?
I need a patrol unit to transport a suspect back to Central.
Certainly, Detective. You have a message from the coroner. Do you wish to be put through?
Yes, ma'am.
Carruthers.
It's Phelps.
I've completed the autopsy. Several wounds to the head from a blunt metal instrument. Closest match would be a socket wrench handle.
So the cause of death was the blunt?
No, the blows to the head surprisingly were not fatal. Death was from hemorrhage and shock from the fractured ribs and multiple injuries caused by the stomping.
Anything else?
He's some kind of sex fiend. The tissues of the anus were bruised about 1/8 of an inch, but no trace of semen in the anus, vagina, or stomach.
Thanks, Doc. Operator, give me R&I. Any word on an owner for that vehicle? License was 2BOY8899?
Yes, Detective. The plate belongs to a brown 1936 Pontiac. Registered owner is one Alonzo Mendez of 402 South Fremont Street, apartment 16.
Thanks. Any other messages?
One, Detective. from Captain Donnelly. He wants any and all suspects returned to Central. Interviews to be set up immediately.
Got it. We're coming in.
Alonzo Mendez. Sound like a man who moonlights as the werewolf?
Don't sound like a man I'd let my daughter in.
You've got a daughter.
Spend enough time drinking, Cole, you'll find yourself with any number of things around here.
So that's why you never sober up.
Exactly.
Brothers,
left, next intersection. Slow and steady, come on!
Brothers said she took a real pounding.
Maybe if he had been a little firmer in the beginning, he wouldn't be in this situation now.
I imagine that Neanderthal routine is a big hit with...
Did you read about the woman who stabbed her husband and pushed him in front of the car? That's the cop that caught her!
Mendez, apartment 16. Here, the apartment's up on the top floor.
Don't bother knocking, just kick the door in. Take a look around and see what you can find.
Brothers could match the color and brand of the body. Consistent with Celine's injuries, and the blood can be typed.
We have the murder weapon. We better get Pinker down here.
Why keep it? Why not throw it away?
You think these clowns are geniuses? Thank your stars you caught a break, and Captain Donald will begin to like you.
Hey, what gives? LAPD, you're under arrest.
Do not lose that son of a bitch. I'll go get our wheels.
Mendez, stop right there. You don't need to do this, Alonzo.
Got an idea. Get him next to my window, Cole. Keep me alongside his vehicle, and I'll stop this son of a bitch. Hit him. Clean this asshole off the road. I'll try to shoot out his tires. Wish me luck.
You're under arrest for the murder of Celine Henry.
Show me your hands.
I ain't saying a goddamn thing.
You did a grand job, lads. Phelps, that's quite a way to acquit yourself in your first outing as a homicide investigator. It seems the city has a new and vengeful guardian. Considering the evidence against your suspect and the thoroughness with which your report was compiled, I foresee a safe passage through the courts, and the DA agrees with me. Brutality on a scale such as this deserves retribution. The people and the press of this city demand it.
This pain to cool the lava you pump through my veins, 'cause I'm burning, I'm burning out for you.